and gives him clear observation of the land and the culture and the way people are acting in the culture. He lets them know that there is a sense of violence. There is a sense of oppression. He lets them know that there's a sense of wickedness, tragedy. There's a sense of dehumanizing the creation of God. And here, what really grabs my mind as I begin to talk back and forth with God is that the God we serve knows all. Yes. The God we serve need nothing. Yes. Because he is self-sufficient. Yes. The God we serve can do anything that he wants to do. The God we serve, co-pastor, is limitless. Uh-huh. He can change a situation. Just my thought. But yet in this text, in the world that he created and in the culture that has developed in the world that created, he had a problem. And the problem was that he needed a man to resolve the problem. But the question is, what kind of man was he really looking for? Because he knows all things.
Yes.
He's everywhere at all times. He knows you and I inside out.
Yes, sir.
But then, after observing how mankind was treating mankind, he gives a peculiar question. He said, I saw a man.
My Lord.
Among them that would make up the hedge, stand in the gap. But after the all-knowing God observes what he need to do or need to happen to resolve the problem, he comes back and says, but I couldn't find
him.
We got men among us. But there's a particular man or man type that he's looking for. You can be a man but not a man. Let me put it like that. And the reason why this type of man is needed is because we live in a world where human hedges of life has been breached. We live in a world where the coverings of the gaps of life have been broken. They have been broken by Satan, who comes to siege and to ravage generations upon generations of women and wives and young girls and baby girls. And don't forget, he comes to ravage the lives of men and young men and baby boys. We live in a reality time that years ago we thought it would never happen. The comfort zone of life survival has been breached, and the gap of it has been broken open. The statistic says one person is murdered every 31 minutes. One person is raped every 1 minute. Every aggravated assault is admitted every 36 seconds. One child is abused and neglected every 34 seconds. One in six men between the ages of 18 to 34 in the U.S. is incarcerated. On the average, 4,500 men are killed by other men annually. Suicide rate for men has risen to an all-time high of 80%. Homicide, unmerciful killing from those that have been demonized in the police force, to those that are terrorists from foreign countries, to those that are gang bangers in this United States that we live in, has risen 76%. This evidence is also gives way to this through the dastardly deeds of unmerciful killing, from the lynching of black slavery to the Holocaust, to the lynching of the Jewish people, to the killing of the World Trade Center on 9/11, to the slaughtering of elementary and high school children, to the peace walk with those that walk for peace and try to convey the need to cure cancer, experienced a bomb that killed many. When people walked into churches and shot up those that were in their Bible studies. To random single murders of women and men. To not too many days ago, one driven by a demon walked into a nightclub and committed a mass murder. We live in a time that is oppressed. We live in a time that is no longer fiction. It is reality. We live in a time that is no more a cartoon or a game that we play. But it is a reality that when you walk out your door, you don't know what's going to happen. Please hear me. Human dignity and the value and the worth of the protective hedges of life have been breached.
Yes, sir.
And the perpetuating connections to pass down traditions of good family principles have been dismantled.
Yes,
by broken gaps of sin and dysfunction and the manipulation of self-destruction.
Yes.
Known as genocide. Genocide conveys a killing of culture, a killing of a group of people that is designed to be productive in life. But yet we get in our cars every day, and we live in our home every day, and we go about our own lives, not thinking about the dangers that lurk all around us. And as men, we're driven to follow the American dream that you work hard so you can have something. But yet, there has been a gap that has been laid wide open. There has been hedges that has been pulled down. And the enemy has come in now to snatch away that which we have most value of, human life itself. We live in a time of torn down hedges and satanically manipulated breaches within the human fiber of quality of living. As a God-fearing nation, according to God's plan of salvation, to recover all mankind so that we can live in the kingdom of God and enjoy life. Two key words in this text that I read to you today, brothers and sisters, two key words that I want to convey to you, that there is a clarion call upon. The word call warning simply means a call of urgency.
Yes, sir.
A call of war.
Jesus.
A call to come back to the original intent. The two words are hedge and gap. When you think about a hedge is a boundary form so it can keep out intruders and keep in the precious. It is to protect something or a group of people or a culture against a loss. God wants us to understand, just like in Ezekiel day, that the hedge has been pulled down. The protective boundaries that should be in place in our culture, in our homes, in our churches, to keep out intruders and to protect and keep the precious covered, has been torn down. The gap has been spread. The word gap means an open split. It means an open void. It means unconnected parts. It means misunderstanding.